No need to clap, please. Okay. Everybody must have heard of Wormy.
It's okay.
Everybody must have heard of vermicompost. So basically, vermicompost is like an earthworm. Basically, vermicompost is earthworm droppings. So what? When the earthworm starts eating the matter, like either there could be some leaves or cow dung or whatever. When the earthworm is and they eject it out, they basically defecate it out. That is actually the castings of the. That is the castings of its.
Unidirectional. Unidirectional.
Okay, so the castings of the worms or the what they defecate is basically vermicompost. So it's many people struggle about vermicompost. See, the main one of the main this like what I use at the farm. I use a earthworm variety called Aisinia fetida. That is supposed to be one of the fastest. They digest raw material fastest. So usually I use Aisinia fetida, and with that I've got very good results. I make around 40 to 50,000 kgs of vermicompost every month. And my main ingredient that I use for the vermicompost is cow dung. Cow dung is the main thing because in cow dung they eat it also very fast and they multiply very fast. Like you can. If you put cow dung in 1 month, you'll find your earthworm population increasing by 3 or 4 times. Not dry cow dung. Okay, now I'll explain how to do it. See, I've got best results with cow dung. Oh, otherwise what I do, I got a very big machine in which we can powder even blocks of wood. It can be made powder in like cocoa peat size. So that can be mixed and that the smaller the it's easier for the earthworms to eat and to digest and to defecate. So basically, I prefer to do with cow dung and a little bit. I've got a lot of trees around, so I prefer to do with whatever waste I get around. So mainly, I've shown today with cow dung. So you are asking me about the cow dung. So the cow dung should be about 15 to 20 days old, or a max 1 month old. If you use too fresh cow dung, what happens? Cow dung starts decomposing. When it decomposes, it releases methane gas and it heats up quite a lot, you know. I mean, when it heats up, anything decomposes, whether it is leaves or whatever organic material decomposes, it generates heat. So that heat, as far as I know, I've tested it, is about 70-80 degrees centigrade inside. You can't even keep your hand inside. That hot it gets. So that heat will kill your earthworms. So basically, I prefer to use about 15-20 days old. This, or the best thing to use, but not everybody can do it, is to use the gobar gas for your biogas output. So because that is already about 20-25 days before it comes out from the tank. And the methane is already out from that. So you could use that or you could use, but I prefer cow dung because cow dung is.
Suppose we get to zero, because here there's no one who's got.
No, but you can get wet cow dung on the road. Fresh cow dung.
Or the dry packs, you know, the
No. It has to be, if it's too old, it doesn't get digested. They don't eat it very well. So basically it has to be about 15 to 30 days old. You'll get the best results with that. So I've not brought much. I brought, you can check out also. What is Nagaya Masa? 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 So basically this is normal cow dung. This is cow dung, which is about 15 to 20, 30 days old. And what you have to do is, you have to wet it. See, when you wet the cow dung also, you should see that it is not very wet. When it is very wet, no, it doesn't go. So you should get about 2 or 3 drops when you press it out.
This is just cow dung.
This is about 20-25 days old. So if you keep it too wet also, no, then the earthworms don't do well. So basically when you squeeze, you should get a few drops out. That is the best. So this is just cow dung. So what I do is I just make a, people say they use dry matter and other things. If you have it, you can use it, but with cow dung also it works just fine. And I'm talking from the practical viewpoint because I make 40,000. I'm selling outside at the rate of 12 rupees a kilo. A big bag of 20 kgs, 250. And if you want loose, at the rate of 15 rupees a kilo. But I'm planning to make about 2 lakh kgs a month, where I'm planning to drop the prices to below 10. So everybody can afford. But even now at the moment even 12 rupees is vermicompost. Even now 12 rupees also I think is quite cheap because nobody has, most of the people sell 15, 20, 25 and plus. So you can get it outside at my stall for 15 if you are buying 1 kilo or more, or if you are buying a full bag of 20 kgs, you can get it for 250 rupees. So basically what you do is you collect 15 to 20 days cow dung. So what we do is I do two things. You can either make your vermicompost, you get these ready-made vermi beds. You know, they are about 4 feet by 12 feet by about 3, 4 feet wide, 12 feet long and about 3 feet high. 2 feet high. So we fill the cow dung in that. We put little bit, we got dry matter, we mix dry matter with that. And then we spread it out this way. And see, one more thing, when you're using the cow dung, it should not be big blocks. It should be as loose as possible. So you keep it as loose as possible. And you spread it along. So what we do, if we are doing it on a floor, we do it, I do on a concrete floor also. So we make a bed. The bed will be about 3 feet wide. And it will be about, you can keep lengthwise how much you want. It will be about 2 feet in height at the most. And it will be sort of a mountain shape, a hill shape, so that it tapers at the ends. And it's high in the middle. So you make that bed and you set it up and you can keep it as long as possible. And preferably one more thing when you're doing vermicomposting, see that you have space on either side, on all the four sides. Yeah, buy it to the border. On all the four sides so you can work on it. Because there is some work that you have to do. It's not that you just put the worms and it doesn't happen that way. So once you put this, you spread this out. Yeah, cut the earthworm cut. Where is that? So this actually I've brought earthworm. You can take a look around over here. You can see there are a lot of earthworms inside over here. Can come closer and take a look. Huh? These are the earthworms, these are these Icenia fetida earthworms.
Where do you buy them?
Actually I brought them from somewhere, but now I was selling in between, but now I stopped selling because I'm increasing my capacity.
Do they multiply easily?
Then within a month, by the time your compost is ready, they increase about 3 to 4 times. Especially when you make it in cow dung. And when you make this in cow dung, it is much faster than when you make it in leaves. So basically what we do is we leave this on the top. And these earthworms, they don't like light. So usually they go right down. See, you can see within some time, you won't see any of the earthworms on the top. They'll all go down.
So these are fully grown or are they the small ones?
These are always small ones, they are not very big. The Icenia fetida are not the big long ones that you see. They are the small ones. You can just write the name down, it's Icenia fetida, and they are the best for, I think they are from Australia if I am not mistaken, but they are the best for vermicomposting. So basically what we do is we just put this and we keep the earthworms, we make small holes over here and we just throw the earthworms on the top. One more thing, when you are storing earthworms, see that there is always matter for them to eat. If you keep earthworms loose as it is, they will die off and they will, so there should always be matter for them to eat. And that matters is the same matter that should be there for them. You cannot have it too early, like if your compost is only about 3 or 4 days old. There will be so much heat generated in that the earthworm will die off. And then secondly, you should see that you don't use material that has got pesticides or something in it, because the earthworms are very sensitive to that. They will die off immediately.
Any
illustration?
What about carbon?
Okay, so now once you put this in, cow dung, you can use leaves and everything. But as far as possible, I got a machine that makes leaves into powder. It makes even wood into powder. Means powder, I am talking about cocoa peat type of powder. So that's easier for them to digest.
How do you use chicken
waste? Pardon? Actually, it should be composted. It should be composted. And how you can confirm if it's composted properly is you can put your hand in that and check whether this, if it's hot, the composting thing is still going on. See, dry is one thing and composted is something. That dry still holds that methane and everything, it's just dried. Like you're talking about cow dung on the road, it's just dried. But it's not composted. Composted cow dung is different. So basically I've used composted about 15, 20 days old, it's all the methane has gone out. And if you see now, the earthworm just go inside. So what we do is after we make this, you cover it with either this sacks, gunnies, jute bag sacks, or I use green netting on the top. What happens is, now earthworms are very sensitive to light. So now there's light over here. They'll go down, they won't come up. But when they start eating,
they start eating from the top. Earthworms don't start eating from the top. They start eating from the top. So what we do is we cover it with gunny bags. And like you have to water it every 2 days or 3 days. You don't water it every day. If you make it too wet, it will not. You should see this consistency of wetness. You should get about 3 or 4 drops when you press. Water should not be dripping like continuously. So if you cover that on the top, then there's no light reaching this thing. You should see that no light reaches on the top. So you cover with your jute bags, you put some plantain leaves. If you got, you can put some plantain leaves on the top, you put some jute bags on the top, or you put green netting. I'm using green netting at the moment. So when you use that green netting and no light goes inside, then the earthworms start eating from the top. After about 15 days, you will see a tea powder like of consistency on the top. A tea powder. So that is actually their droppings, the compost. The vermicompost is that. That tea powder is their vermicompost. So around after a month it starts forming on the top. Vermicompost already forms on the top, not on the bottom. The earthworms start eating from the top and they go to the down. So every 2 or 3 days you start raking it a bit, making that material a bit loose. And when you want to do the harvesting of the vermicompost, you keep the pit open for about a day or two, so that the earthworms go down, they don't remain on the top. So after you keep it open for 2 days, then you can start removing the top layer. The top layer is already, you can make out it's done, because it will not be this, it will be like tea powder. Like if you take a look at this, this is sort of, this was this, this is, anybody can see, this is actual vermicompost.
Pretty wet.
It's little bit, this is the normal wetness that is there in it. This is the normal wetness that is there in it. You cannot have totally dry, they will not survive in totally dry. But basically, if you press it, you should see that there's no moisture falling out, you know, means maybe a drop or so. What people do is to increase their weight. There are two things that they do. You find online they're giving for 8 rupees and 7 rupees. They do two things. There is something called pressed mud. Pressed mud is basically waste of sugarcane. It's black in color. And Kolhapur and all these sugar growing areas, they get a lot of that. So that's what they mix. Otherwise, they use a lot of water. Like you take for instance this, what we do not add water. What we add is what is used in the process. What water you require for the process, not more than that. No. The water, we don't exude excess. See, water gives you weight. Like if you see some vermicompost, they'll have about 30-40% of water also. So you're basically paying for the water. So that's the way we do it actually. And just before harvesting, a day or so, you keep it open on the top and start raking it, making it a bit loose. You get these rakes, you know, which can be caught in the hand. It's got 5 or 6 teeth, I think. And just pull it, loosen that soil over there. Loosen the vermicompost over there, and then you can keep on harvesting. You cannot harvest vermicompost over the full thing over a period of 1 day. Harvest slowly, slowly, slowly. Mean the vermi bed, we take about 6 to 7 days or maybe 10 days also to harvest the full thing. And in the end, you'll find a huge concentration of earthworms down. So before you reach about 6 or 8 inches, that is your earthworm, this, what is that, your new earthworms, everything are there in that. You can add that to a new bed. If you keep it too long, what will happen is the earthworm will run out of food and they'll die off.
Or you keep putting stuff on top of that?
No, we don't keep on top of that. We'll make a new bed again once we finish this off. We remove the earthworm, we keep it aside, then we fill the bed again and then we put it back again.
So is there any soil contact in this? You put any
absolutely
soil
no soil. This is only cow dung or leaves or something. There's
just
no soil. Yes, then nothing else. Leaves or sticks or whatever organic matter. We put even the coconut tree leaves.
Kitchen waste,
I don't use kitchen waste because kitchen waste gets contaminated with many things. And most of the stuff that we eat also is not actually organic. But like cows and all, no doubt.
Cow dung.
I prefer to do it cow dung because cow dung, and I get, see, I bought my farm in a jungle area. We get lot of leaves and all, so we first chaff it and then we powder it. And so I can add it to that. But the result that I got with cow dung are much better than the result that you get with the other things. So, any questions?
Cows are also from your farm.
Yeah, cows are from my farm, but I buy, because I'm making a huge quantity, you know, I buy cow dung from elsewhere.
What is the time taken from the first day?
Just a request.
Yeah.
See, it's a very detailed subject and I'm sure there are many questions, many answers. The idea of these talks is just to give a starting point.
I'll be having a program practically at my farm very soon. I'll inform, we'll put it on the groups.
Of course. And also, now you can carry on the interaction outdoors at Nestor's stall. He's there to answer all the questions. But any wider questions if you...
Yeah, tell me. You mentioned about gunny bags.
Yes.
To cover the...
Yes.
That is jute bags.
Right? Jute bags.
Right. And another is whether biopesticides will affect the...
See, actually, I tell you, I don't use biopesticides. One more thing I forgot to do. Usually, in most of my this, during the process only, we spray a consortium of bacteria. That consortium, you know what happens? Like, even if you see the nutrient content of this, the micronutrients are negligible. Micronutrients, but it gives life to your soil. The micronutrients and your other nutrients like potassium, NPK are hardly 1%. Like if you want to make an equivalent of 1 kg of urea, you'll have to use 46 kg of that because urea has got 46% of. Or you say 19 is a complex fertilizer. It has got 19% of N, 19% of P, and 19% of K. You'll have to use 19 kg of this to make something equivalent of that. So it's very, but what this has got is lot of beneficial microorganisms. So what I do is there's a friend of mine who has isolated some microorganisms. So those organisms, they help in, there are about 13 different organisms. Some of the work I do is nitrogen fixing, then potassium soluble, PSB bacteria. Then there is something that they stabilize the pH of the soil. Because see, most of our trees, if you see, you know, they require pH about 5.5 to 7. If it is less than that, the soil is too acidic, they don't grow. If it is alkaline, so the soil is, it doesn't grow. So when you put that particular bacteria that I use, it stabilizes the pH of the soil. Then there's another bacteria in that, it's called, it breaks the ion chain. So what it happens, it breaks the ion chain of the micronutrients, and those micronutrients are absorbed easily by the plant. Same way with the NPK bacteria that are there, it breaks down and makes the nutrients easily available to the plant.
Yeah.
So, any other questions? But this will go on and on and on. Pardon?
What food for the...
The cow dung is their food.
That's it.
Say
some leaves or something.
Pardon?
Leaves.
Green. Not green. It has to be composted leaves. You have to keep your leaves for 15 days, 20 days. And then check whether it's heated up or not. If it's still hot, please do not use it because it will die.
Not just
dry leaves. You have to make them wet, compost it. Just drying leaves is different. See, dried is different and composted is different. Like even if you buy, if you bring dry compost from somewhere, in a day your cow dung can dry on the road if it's hot. But if you put water again, that this water, that methane and all will start getting released and the composting activity will take place.